sabotage for instruction. Took on a harder, grittier kind of approach. Now, in the last part of the lecture, how much time do we have?
5 minutes.
5 minutes. In the last part of the lecture, I want to deal with that artist who took off into a geometric abstraction, very much influenced by the Judas. This is the other direction of 20th century art. He was a Dutchman named Piet Mondrian. Mondrian was a member of a sort of arts class movement in the Netherlands known as the Stiel movement that included design, ornamental design, and hence took on an element of abstraction in its own way. This is true also of other abstract trends, that they were alive with arts and crafts, a tradition which emphasized ornamental abstraction. But I want to show once again that that Mondrian abstracts from reality. Began very early on doing these churches on strong vertical. And then he also very much involved with landscape that showed a strong horizontal movement. Mondrian also was a member of the Theosophical group, the Dutch Theosophical organization that he took off in a different direction from Kandinsky. But he thought that he could see the higher truth through a certain visual model of design that stressed universal harmony and equilibrium. But that could be a model that people exposing that in the entire environment they would begin to live in a more harmonious way. And hence this tree, vertical, gradually the tree begins to break down into increasingly abstract patterns. And begins to develop a kind of a grid-like quality that is very familiar to us in the Mondrian Hotel on Sunset Boulevard. Again, another example of the grid-like. Questions about